Woohoo! You're not gonna believe what I cooked up this time, ladies and gentlemen. I give to you baby Wall-E. Just kidding, I wouldn't do that to you guys. This here is actually baby Wall-E. A couple months ago, I was brainstorming gift ideas for somebody very dear to me. And so far, what I had come up with was some kind of little robot that I could use to deliver gifts. Now, what robot already has a little compartment built into it? Trash compactor? Wall-E. Now, Wall-E ended up being the perfect candidate for this project, as he's cute, lovable, as well as just super cool, and perfect for delivering gifts. I also knew I wanted to make him as small as possible to maximize cute factor. For starters, the main constraint I used for deciding the size of the main housing were these two N20 DC motors that drive Wall-E's tracks. They needed to be back-to-back lengthwise with enough room in between that I could slide them into position. That gave me a length of 6 centimeters. Add 2mm buffer on each side for the shell, and boom. I knew the dimensions I was shooting for. Now it's just a matter of making everything else fit. Let's talk about everything that goes into making a baby Wall-E. We have one Arduino Nano, an HM10 Bluetooth chip, one H-bridge, a 7.4 volt LiPo, a speaker, an amplifier for the speaker, 5 servos, an LED, 2 resistors, a switch, a button, and then of course the 2 motors. I swapped the speaker and amplifier for this speaker module, which has a built-in amplifier, but I'm also adding this butt converter to keep a consistent 5 volts so baby Wall-E doesn't look like he's having a seizure. Not to mention all the wire that connects everything. Do you feel my pain yet? Alas, I set aside all my doubt and could in fact fit everything into the main housing. I finished designing all the other parts I would need, which started the vicious cycle of SolidWorks, coffee. SolidWorks, coffee. SolidWorks, you guessed it, more coffee. For the tracks, I wanted them to be fully 3D printed, so I made the track itself out of a flexible TPU. To support them, I rigged up this support with 2 posts that 2 rider bearings could cruise on and attempt to make the system somewhat smooth. It took a couple tries to really perfect it, but once I got it down, it worked out really good, and Wall-E became an off-roading beast. The compartment opens and closes using a servo with some wire attached to it that runs up to the compartment door. I used a tiny linear servo with floss tied to the servo horn, and then routed up a small tube to the back of the neck. The head is designed to be heavier in the front, so naturally tilt down. That way I could just pull on the back to raise and lower it. This little servo is pretty weak, so to increase mechanical advantage, I added an additional piece to the head that moves the connection point further from the axis of rotation, hence giving us more torque. The arms slide together, and the shoulder joint hooks right into a servo on each side with a screw to keep them in place. Now believe it or not, as crazy as it might seem, this entire project runs off of this Arduino Nano. To get around this, I had to get really creative with the coding. For example, instead of having all the servos connected at the same time, which involves a lot of jittering and Wall-E looking like he's about to explode, I built one main function that takes in a servo ID, the pin it's connected to, the mount you want it to move, and its current position as parameters. It then attaches it so we can manipulate it and then detach it once that change has been made. This allowed me to control all the servos smoothly and individually. Now I wanted baby Wall-E to have 2 different modes. One for when he's not being controlled via Bluetooth. He'll kind of just hang out and do his own thing. And then for 2, when he is being controlled via Bluetooth, which is activated by long pressing this button right here, he'll do whatever you tell him to do.
The code for these 2 modes can be found under the Autonomous Mode tab and the Bluetooth Mode tab.
Now if any of you coding wizards out there feel like making some dance moves for baby Wall-E, that would be awesome and I would love to see it.
For Bluetooth control, I'm using an app called Dabble, which gives you a game controller-like feel and lets you customize all the buttons to complete specific tasks. For instance, the arrows on the left let me drive baby Wall-E around. By pressing the start button, it opens and closes the compartment door, and the buttons on the right can be set to run different actions. For example, by pressing triangle, Wall-E will walk through a program sequence such as I have here. Also, if you're wondering what this long number is, this is Wall-E's voice that's been converted into an array of numbers, which when played through the speaker, sounds like this. Now baby Wall-E 1.0 was a wiring nightmare, and I was constantly taking it apart to reconnect wires. To fix this, I designed this circuit board for small robotic projects just like this that has outputs for 5 servos and 2 motors, as well as all the electrical components. It pops right onto the main housing and makes connecting everything so much easier and so much more reliable.
For the circuit board, I'll make sure to link to a Gerber file, that way you can have some made using a manufacturer such as JLC PCB or PCBWay. Or if you don't want to go through that hassle, I plan on setting up a little website where you can order these, and they'll come with the 2 JST connectors you need for the motors, as well as 1 JST connector for the linear servo. Now, also on that website, you might find a limited edition Professor Boots hoodie, which will only be available pre-1,000 subscribers. So make sure you check that out if you're interested. All the proceeds from this will go right back into the next DIY robotics learning project. If you're not confident that you could put one of these together just yet with the info provided, no worries. The next upcoming video will be a step-by-step build process where we're going to go through every detail. That way, you can be sure that you'll get it right the first time. Now, this project is completely DIY, meaning all the CAD files, all the wiring diagrams, all the code will be linked down below so that if you feel like making one, you hopefully have all the resources. I'll also make sure to include links to all of the electrical components down as well. Keep in mind that this project is definitely intermediate to advanced, as there is some soldering that has to happen. I hope you enjoyed this build and that you build one for yourself. If you do, be sure to let me know in the comments below or tag me in the old Instagrams linked below. Thank you so much for watching and have fun tinkering.